Well, I could have seen our boat. Made it down there.
Sing me a song of a lass that is gone. Say, could that lass be I? Mary of soul, she sailed on a day over the sea to sky.
There are good ships and wooden ships, ships that sail the sea, but the best ships are friendships, may they always be. Irish proverb.
No. Pretty steep incline climbing that.
It is time to climb Monument. I first shared Monument as we entered Elizabeth Harbor as one of the many anchorages. It's also a hike everyone says to make, especially to see all the names of the boats in the sand below. Monument is located on Stocking Island, and according to Wikipedia, Stocking Island is a lightly inhabited with a population of only 10. It's located 1 mile from the government dock, Georgetown, across the harbor. The long, narrow island protects Georgetown from ocean waves, creating a natural harbor. There is one high hill, known locally as the Beacon, which is capped with an old, unused gas beacon. The glass top portion is missing, but the concrete pillar is visible for miles.
Well, I could have seen our boat. Made it down there.
The central part of Stocking Island features an inlet known as a hurricane hole, where sailboats anchor for protection during storms. Opposite the hurricane hole is a sandbar beach, where locals have built a popular bar and restaurant accessible only by boat, known as Chat and Chill. After reaching the peak of Monument and taking our selfie, it was time to explore the Exuma side of Stocking Island and the beaches. So we're off to find a trail to the beach. Starting to sound close. Oh, wow. Thank you. We enjoyed hanging out on North Beach and discovering the hidden beauty we find so many places in the Bahamas. As always, I enjoyed picking up shells, photo op for us both as we posed on the beach, and finally getting some sun before heading over to the Peace and Plenty Beach Club for a hot dog and rum punch, which Cruiser said was a must stop for a quick meal on the beach. Finally, the time has come. Our friends on Saltwife, who you first met during our August 2019 boat trip together, arrived in Georgetown. We are super excited to hang out with these two. We closed out the first evening with sundowners on the deck. Before any fun can begin, Scott and Mary arrived just ahead of weather. Wind weather. See all the white caps? 4 days of rocking and rolling in the anchorage with 30 plus mile per hour winds. We thought it was rough and we were pretty protected compared to all the boats exposed in Elizabeth Harbor. Here's some footage from just one day. Now remember, I'm standing behind the boat, so you can't get the full impact of the wind. After 4 days, we all had cabin fever, so it was time to go ashore, find a cold beer, and just be on land. Dee and Scott decided to give the hook and ring game a go, but found the one located at Cheaters near Georgetown a little more difficult.
Wow,
it's a tough one.
It's a tough one. They threw in lowness.
They got some help from some locals on how to play, but still, no one, not even the locals, were able to get the hook on the ring on this day. Mary and I just enjoyed our cold beers. Might I recommend the Kalik Mango Rattler? We did finally get our hands on a Sands beer in Black Point and loved it, but sadly Dorian put this brewery underwater. But they should be back online, probably now as this video comes out.
Now that the winds have stopped, back in our anchorage we're finally able to get out and get to know some more of our neighbors. We had recognized Lawrence in his boat Mini SS, who had anchored near us in Black Point. We stopped by and he invited us aboard for a cold beer and conversation. Lawrence is 81 and from Canada. He keeps his boat stored in Florida and drives down each winter for his annual trip to the Bahamas. Most year he just single hands, but sometimes he does have friends and family join him. In Black Point, he had his daughter and her friend with him. You might think Lawrence's story is unusual, but not really in the cruising world. What is unusual is this. Lawrence has had several strokes. He told us of the one he had right here in Georgetown while alone on his boat. He awoke one morning, and one side of his body was numb and partially paralyzed. He tells how he managed to get himself in the dinghy, get it started, and drive himself the 2 miles into the dock to get help. He made it to a clinic, and a nurse did what she could there, but he would need to go to Nassau to get the treatment he needed. They arranged a flight, but before he could go, he needed to return to the mini-SS to get some clothes and other necessities. The nurse, true to the bohemian nature, went with him to care for him and help him. After his treatment and recovery in Nassau, he returned to his boat and continued his trip, and obviously his passion of being on the water. Nothing will stop him. You can still see the effects of the strokes on his body and speech, but it doesn't slow him down a bit. As we watched him prepare the mini-SS for his trip home, we discussed how he really shouldn't be out here all alone. He should be traveling with a buddy boat at the very least. All thoughts I'm sure his family have also had. But who are we? We are mere novices at this life on the water. Lawrence is our model. We can only hope to achieve the things he already has. Fair winds and following seas, our friend.
And it's not always cold beers and great stories. Sometimes we have to do laundry, which is always an adventure when you live on a boat.
If he's not blowing, you just make honking noises, okay? Come on, do it!
So they have a conch horn as part of this regatta. They do a conch.
Scott was all about making conch horns, and he was no doubt good at making and blowing his conch horn. Dee, on the other hand, well, he's still working on it. We ended the night sharing our lights on the water. Salt Wife is green tonight, and Journey is showing off her blue. Until next time, when we go underwater in Georgetown.
Starboard.